everybody, and welcome to the last episode of the Harambee We Are One miniseries, in which we celebrate hope and unity. I'm Deja.
I'm Skylar, and we are very glad to have hosted the show over the last 3 weeks.
The previous episodes provided powerful messages on Black Lives Matter and the heroes we have lost within the last year. If you happen to miss these episodes, they're posted on the Harambee social media pages.
Also, the Harambee for the Culture Trivia Night will be on Saturday, March 6th at 7 p.m. Get your team together and register by March 4th. The cost is $10 per person.
To conclude our 2021 We Are One miniseries, this episode will begin with a praise dance, encouraging our viewers to stay hopeful throughout the COVID-19 pandemic.
After all, the coronavirus is the only reason for our virtual show this year. With that being said, following the praise dance, we will hear personal student responses to the pandemic.
I have my sister, Leandria, here. She's going to help me share this wisdom and tell this story.
Lord, deliver me, 'cause all I seem to do is hurt me. Hurt me, Lord, deliver me, 'cause all I see to do is hurt me.
Yes, sir.
Lord, deliver me, 'cause all I see to do is hurt me. Hurt me.
One more time.
About the bad side of this pandemic. Sure, many people have lost loved ones, and so have I. But during this time, there was also good that happened. I usually be busy with organizations, cheerleading, church, and volunteer work on weekends. But when the pandemic came, everything stopped. I was able to spend more time with my family, learn how to do nails and makeup, and start my modeling portfolio. With that being said, this pandemic was a win, not a loss.
As someone dealing with a non-curable immune deficiency disease, 2020 was hard. Throughout the year, I was in and out of the hospital caused by me having sickle cell anemia. While being in the hospital, not being able to have any visitors besides my parents, and not being able to go outside of those four walls, I became very sad. But my faith grew much stronger. I began to really understand the Word of God And if it wasn't for my faith and my family, I would not be here telling my story of how I got through 2020.
My quarantine has had some highs and lows. Being at home all the time can really drive you crazy. I'm a family person, and my family loves getting together on the weekends. We normally have parties for no reason at all. But since the lockdown, we haven't really been able to see each other, and that hurts us all. I used to go over to my grandma's house almost every single day, and now the only way I get to see her is if she sits in the car and I sit on the porch. But the best thing about it is I still get to see her. But 2020 really hasn't been that bad of a year if you look at it from a positive side, because it taught us all how to adjust to new things.
The year of 2020 was a hard year for me, but it brought me closer to my sister because I got to see her. When the lockdown first started, I was upset because I never got to have my first track meet as a sophomore. It made me feel like all my goals were unachievable, and I started to tell myself that I should quit everything. When making the transition to Zoom calls, it made me realize that I should not let this pandemic stop me, and it taught me that in life, you will face challenges but have to find ways to overcome them.
My lockdown experience was unforgettable, to say the least. Well, locked up for months, I wasn't able to talk to my friends or really express myself in any way, and I fell into a small depression. Until I found TikTok. All of my ideas I had to bundle up, I was now finally able to express. It was like a light at the end of the tunnel. Over lockdown, I was able to get more in touch with my creative side. And that's what made it memorable. And you can find me on TikTok at FirstPrincessSomething. Ayy.
This pandemic has really allowed me to step away from people and just learn about myself more. Between spending quality time with my family and doing some excessive cleaning, I've grown to find creative solutions to new problems the pandemic has challenged me with. From online community service to filming theatrical productions, I've been keeping myself safely busy. Thanks to this pandemic, I've learned to find some creative talents of mine I wouldn't have found otherwise.
Trying to stay safe during this pandemic has made everyone feel pretty isolated. And for a very social person, the change was huge. And that's why I've taken this time to focus and learn more about myself. Expressing my emotions through my art and practicing my tattooing technique improved my mental health a lot with creativity, just like so many other people. Choose not to focus on how alone you are, because once we're all together and outside again, you'll wish you had a lot more time at home alone.
In the beginning of the pandemic, I was fine because I finally felt as if I was getting a break from my overbooked schedule. But the common effect of 2020 did come to me. My relationships with certain family members deteriorated, and my senior year in my eyes was gone. But luckily, faculty and staff was able to give us something involving clubs and sports. Though restricted, it gives us some kind of normalcy. Just like most of us, I struggled mentally. But I never focused on what I lost, but what I have and what I still gained. My glass was never half empty, it was always half full.
Last year, I spent the majority of my year working on a show all about mental health and the importance of it, without knowing how hard it would affect me in the months to come. During the pandemic, I had to go through a lot of changes that became too fast to try to adjust to. With the stress of online school and getting my first job and trying to join as many groups as I can to pick up the slack due to COVID. I started to feel more and more stress and anxiety, which eventually led to depression. But I started feeling better about my situation when I talked to others who was feeling the exact same way that I felt. And then that's when I realized that COVID-19 didn't only bring us down throughout this year, but that it also helped bring a lot of us together.
When the pandemic first hit, we was all forced to quarantine. I had to adjust to staying at home and finishing my junior year off virtually. Cooking was my way to stay busy and entertained, creating new recipes, exploring with different foods. I wouldn't have discovered this talent if it wasn't for this pandemic. I also had the opportunity to become more spiritual and explore the importance of meditation. Emerging into these different practices really helped me stay mentally stable. So go out, use this opportunity to find your gift, use your talent, and create your own happiness.
Those were some powerful moves. Just impressive.
I agree, Deja. The COVID-19 responses were thought-provoking as well.
It's crazy that so many people are going through so many different things during COVID-19.
In spite of all the ups and downs of the pandemic, Harambee remains positive throughout it all and continues to uplift its members and countless others.
Well said, Skylar. Now let's check out the Harambee hip-hop dancers.
Working on a weekend like usual. Way off in the deep end like usual. Swear they passed us, they doing too much. Haven't done my taxes, I'm too turned up. Virgil got a paddock on my wrist going nuts. Caught me slipping once, okay, so what? Someone hit your block up, I tell you if it was us. Man, a house in Rosewood, it too plush.
To put me on game, on time, on gold chains, with my old shoe in a jail. Drop all on me. I'm good at that shit, keep it. Hold on, don't ask, I like such a nut, drop by instant. Yo, pure ice, 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 bust down. Bloody, 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 on my wrist out.
Took the time and dedication of not only the members, but also the support of the sponsors, alumni members, and teachers. Thank you all for giving freely of your time to cultivate our vision and teach us choreography. We'd like to give a special thanks to Mr. Chalmers and Mr. Hike for the creative video editing.
Also, thanks to you all for watching. Please continue to like, share, and post our videos. We hope to see you next year in person at our 25th anniversary show. Up next, the Harambee cast will perform the We Are One finale. Us. I'm Deja.
And I'm Skylar.
And this has been the Harambee
We Are One mini series.
Goodbye, y'all.